Hello students, today we are going to see the subject theory of machine second. In that first one, the topic number 2, that is twisted gears or simply gears, or it is also called as a twisted wheels. I am Mr. YY Kamble, Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Edra. Now introduction of this twisted wheels. So what is meant by twisted wheels or gears? Our gears are used to transmit motion from one shaft to another or between a shaft and a slide. This is the main use of these gears. This is main part is what? To transmit motion from one shaft to another. This is accomplished by successively engaging teeth. Okay. Gears are no intermediate link or connector and transmit the motion by direct contact. That means we see in theory of machine 1, that is a intermediate link or connector. This is used to transmit motion from one shaft to another. Here gears are no intermediate link or connector. They can transmit the motion by direct contact. In this method, the surface of two bodies make tangential contact. The two bodies make a tangential contact. Now the friction wheel and toothed wheels. So see here, in figure A, the friction wheels are there, and in figure B, toothed wheels are there. Suppose let the wheel A be keyed to a rotating shaft and wheel B to the shaft to be rotated. A little consideration will show that when the wheel A is rotated by rotating shaft, it will be rotated the wheel B in the opposite direction as shown in figure A. That is, suppose wheel A is rotating, then what happens in opposite direction? We will also rotate. Okay, this is what wheel A drives the wheel B in opposite direction. That means, suppose A rotated in clockwise direction, then wheel B will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. The wheel B will rotate by wheel A. So as long as tangential force exerted by the wheel A does not exceed the maximum frictional resistance between the two wheels. That means the tangential force does not exceed the minimum or maximum frictional resistance between the two wheels. But when the tangential force exceeds the frictional resistance, at that case what happens? Slipping will take place between the two wheels. Thus the friction drive is not positive drive. That means this friction drive is not positive drive. Likewise, the belt chain drives, these are the not positive drive. Only the twisted wheels are positive drives. So in order to avoid the slipping, so what becomes here? The number of projections, that is provision is taken here in friction wheels. We produce the projections, that is called as a teeth, as shown in figure B, are provided on the periphery of the wheel A, which will fit into the corresponding recesses of the periphery of wheel B. That means we made the projections on wheel A, and this projections fits into the recesses of the wheel B, and the engaging of teeth is there, and this will transmit the motion from one shaft to another. Now next is what? Advantages and disadvantages of gear drive. The following are the advantages and disadvantages of gear drive as compared to belt drive, rope drive and chain drive. The advantages are, first one is it transmit exact velocity ratio. That means there is no slippage or no slipping is there. That means it transfer exact velocity ratio. It may use to transmit large power. Earlier we seen that the friction wheels are used to transmit a small power. Their slippage is there, that's why it is used to only transfer small power. And here gear drive are used to transmit large power. it has high efficiency because efficiency losses, that means friction losses are minimum here, or the slipping is not here. That's why it has high efficiency. It has reliable service. Fifth one is what? It has a compact layout. These are the advantages of gear drive. Again, every coin has two sides, that is advantages. Again, disadvantages may be there. So what are the disadvantages of gear drive? First one is what? The manufacturing of gear requires special tools and equipment. For the projection of these teeth, there special tools are required and special equipment is required for manufacturing of gears. Here, this is what? First disadvantage. Second one is what? The error in cutting teeth may cause vibration and noise during operations. That means if we select a gear and we mount on any machine, then if the cutting of teeth is not proper, then what happens? It causes vibration or noise during operation. Now next is what? Classification of these tooth wheels or gears. The gears or tooth wheels may be classified as follows. First, classification based on first, according to position of axis of the shaft. There means according to the shaft, position of the axis of shaft, they classified as follows. The axis of two shafts between which the motion is to be transmitted may be, first one is what? Parallel. Second one is what? Intersecting. And third one is what? Non-intersecting and non-parallel. This is what the position of the shaft means. First, suppose we have taken here two gears or two wheels, a shaft A and shaft B. Suppose the shaft A and B parallel, this is may be considered as a parallel shaft gears. Second one is suppose the shaft A and shaft B intersect each other, then this is nothing but what? Intersecting type of gear is there. And suppose the shaft A and shaft B not intersect each other and they are in one plane, this is what? Or non-parallel, then this type of gear is nothing but what? Non-intersecting and non-parallel. The two parallel and coplanar shafts connected by gears is shown in below figure. These gears are called spur gears and the arrangement is known as spur gearing. This is what suppose these two shafts are parallel, the shaft A and shaft B. Shaft 1 is known as, or shaft A is known as named as driver, and shaft B, this is named as follower. That means the follows the motion of the shaft A or wheel A. And there is a name in figure, line of contact is there, two shafts are there and piece circle is there. Okay, this arrangement is nothing but what? Spur gear. This is what? Spur gear. And arrangement is known as what? Spur gearing. These gears have teeth parallel to axis of wheel as shown in figure. Now next is what? Helical gear. In helical gearing, teeth are inclined to the axis. That means the teeth are inclined to the axis. Helix angle will be there. The single and double helical gears connecting parallel shafts and shown in figure A and figure B respectively. The double helical gears are also known as herringbone gear. So see here, this is figure A and figure B. In figure A, shown as a single helical gear, and in figure B, this is nothing but what? Double helical gear. So what happens here? The teeth are inclined to the axis. The helix angle will be there. And in single helical gear, only single helix angle will be there. And double helical gear, double helical axis, helical angle will be there. Double helical gears are also known as herringbone gears. Next is what? Classification, bevel gear. This classification based on according to the position of the axis of the shaft. The bevel gear, the two non-parallel or intersecting but coplanar shafts connected by gears is shown in figure. This is nothing but bevel gear is named as what? Suppose two non-parallel or intersecting but coplanar. Therefore, these two wheels must be in same plane. This is nothing but what? A bevel gear. These gears are called bevel gears and arrangement is known as bevel gearing. The bevel gears like spur gear may also have their teeth inclined to the face of the bevel, in which case they are known as a helical bevel gear. Now next is what? Spiral gear. In spiral gear, what happens? Two non-intersecting and non-parallel, that is non-coplanar shafts connected by gear as shown in figure. In previous one, in bevel gear, what we seen? In bevel gear, what we seen? That is what? They are in the same plane, that is what? Coplanar is there. Here spiral gear, they are two are not intersecting and non-parallel, that is non-coplanar shafts connected by gears. This is nothing but what? Spiral gear. These gears are called skew bevel gears or spiral gears, and the arrangement is known as a skew bevel gearing or spiral gearing. This type of gearing is also have line contact, the rotation of which about the axis generates the two pitch surfaces known as hyperboloids. Now next is what? Classification based on according to peripheral velocity of gears. That means according to application of velocity, transmission of velocity. The gears according to peripheral velocity of gears may be classified as, first one is what? Low velocity gears. Second one is what? High velocity gears. And third one is what? Second one is what? Medium velocity gears. And third one is what? High velocity gears. So first one is what? We are going to see low velocity gears. So low velocity gears, these gears having velocity less than 3 meter per second as termed as low velocity gears. That means in application the velocity must be less than 3 meter per second. In that case we can use the low velocity gears, or the gears having velocity less than 3 meter per second are termed as low velocity gears. Now next is what? Continue. Medium velocity gears. The medium velocity gears, this is are termed as the gears having velocity between 3 meter per second to 15 meter per second are known as medium velocity gears. Means the in application where the velocity requirement is what? 3 meter per second to 15 meter per second. At that time, we can use the medium velocity gears. The range of the medium velocity gears are 3 meter per second to 15 meter per second. Now, next is what? High velocity gears. If the velocity of gears is more than 15 meter per second, then these are called as high velocity gears. Here, this is what? According to peripheral velocity of the gears, we are classified into three class. First is what? Low velocity gears. This is that in that one velocity is less than 3 meter per second. Second one is what? Medium velocity. In that velocity range is between 3 meter per second to 15 meter per second. And last one is what? High velocity gears. In high velocity gears, the velocity range is more than 15 meter per second. This is called a high velocity gear. Now next is what? Classification of gears according to type of gearing. Now for types of gearing is what? External gearing is there, internal gearing is here, and rack and pinion is there. So first we are going to see external gearing. This is what? Gear A and gear B will be there, or two wheels are there, or they are engagement of teeth, they are engaged externally. So what? See here, the external gears of two shafts meshed externally with each other as shown in figure. This is what? External gearing. So in external gearing, the large of the two wheels are called spur wheel. Larger of these two wheels are called spur wheel, and smaller wheel is called pinion. That means this larger wheel are known as a spur wheel, and this smaller wheel is known called as pinion. Again, in external gearing, the rotation will be unlike. That means, suppose the larger wheel rotates in clockwise direction, then smaller wheel will be rotated in opposite direction, that is anti-clockwise. That means, suppose the spur wheel rotate in clockwise direction, then smaller wheel, that is pinion, will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. In an external gearing, the motion of two wheels are always unlike. Now next is what? Internal gearing. So what is meant by internal gearing? So see here. This is larger wheel is there and smaller wheel are there. They are engaged or engagement of teeth internally. So this is known as what? This figure indicates or what? It is what? Internal gearing. In internal gearing, the gears of two shaft mesh internally with each other as shown in figure. The larger of these two wheels is called annular wheel and smaller wheel is called pinion. In previous external gearing, the larger is known as what? Spur wheel. Here in internal gearing, the larger wheel is known as what? Annular wheel, and smaller wheel is called as pinion. In external gearing, smaller is also called pinion, and internal smaller wheel is also called pinion. Only difference is that what? The larger wheel. In external gearing, larger wheel is known as spur wheel, and here internal gearing, the larger wheel is known as what? Annular wheel. In an internal gearing, the motion of two wheels is always like as shown in figure. This is a major difference between external gearing and internal gearing. In external gearing, the motion of these two wheels always unlike. Here in internal gearing, the motion of these two wheels are always alike. That means, suppose outer wheel, that is annular wheel, rotates in clockwise direction, then pinion is also rotated in clockwise direction, that is in same direction. Now next is what? Rack and pinion. First we seen external gearing, second one is what? Internal gearing, and third one is what? Rack and pinion. So in rack and pinion, sometimes the gear of shaft meshes externally or and internally with the gears in a straight line as shown in figure. Such type of gear is called rack and pinion. That means here shaft meshes externally and internally, both things are there, okay, with the gears in a straight line. That means the position is what? A straight line as shown in figure. That means line of contact or path of contact will be or contact will be a straight line as shown in figure. Such type of gears are called rack and pinion. The straight line gear is called rack and circular wheel is called pinion. Okay, that means straight line gear is there. This is called as a what? Circular wheel and called as a rack, and circular wheel is called as a pinion. Sorry, I repeat once again. The straight line gear is called rack and circular wheel is called as a pinion. See here. This is what? A rack. This is what? A straight line. And smaller circular wheel is there. This is called as a pinion. Now next is what? According to the position of teeth on the gear surface. Now the according to the position of teeth, the straight curve, straight teeth are there, inclined teeth are there, and curved teeth are there. According to that, we are classified the gears. Okay, so first one is what? Straight gears. Okay, the spur gears have straight teeth, whereas helical gears have their teeth inclined to the wheel rim. In spur, what happens? The teeth are straight. Okay, whereas in helical gears, their teeth are inclined to the wheel rim. That is, helix angle will be there. Okay, in case of spiral gears, the teeth are curved over the rim surface. So what happens here? The surface spiral gears, the teeth are curved. This is what internal gears and rack and pinion. So here we can see the straight line teeth are there, inclined teeth are there, and curved teeth are also there. Okay, up to here we can. Thank you. In next lecture, we can see the terminology of gears, that is terminology used in gear. Thank you. Thank you very much.